my name is Katie Geddes, and I am an online music studio owner and teacher business coach. In today's video, I will talk about how to make an Outschool course image. So this is really a Canva for teachers tutorial. If you are getting started on the Outschool platform, then make sure to grab my free guide to getting started on Outschool, which is linked in the description box below. Let's get right to it. So in order to create your photo, you're going to go to canva.com. You need to create an account if you don't already have one. Then we're going to go up to create a design and click on presentation. The sizing isn't going to be completely perfect, but it's pretty much the closest that I've found. You just have to crop it a teeny bit once you import it into the Outschool platform. So then it will automatically create a new file in your Canva account like this. If you want to go ahead and name it, you can just say course listings photo, maybe whatever course you're teaching. So first of all, I highly recommend having a color in your background. So I would just click the background here, click on the little color thing right here, and then you can choose a color to put in your background. They have a bunch to choose from down here. Let's say we're going to choose like a bright blue, a bright pink, you know, something you're teaching kids, right? So you want it to be fun and eye-catching. So I would pick some sort of color for your background. And then depending on what you're teaching, I would add in some photos. So we can go over to elements here. And when you're in elements, you can then search something that is related to your niche. So let's say that we're going to be a piano teacher today. So I would come in here and I would teach, or I would type in piano. So I see a lot of graphics that come up, and you can put in graphics, but I actually prefer going over here to photos and finding a photo that I really like, and then using a feature that I call the remove background feature. And that feature is actually only available for Canva Pro. So you can use it if you pay for Canva Pro, or you can grab a free trial of Canva Pro. If you want to gain access to hundreds of photos, videos, audio, background remover, fonts, templates, then go and find the link in the comments below to grab 1 month free of Canva Pro. So let's say I really liked this photo right here, for example. I could click on it, and then I'm going to go to edit image. And then if you look right here, it has BG remover. So that's background remover. Click on that, and it's going to take a minute to process it. Okay, so you'll see that it just finished processing. So once it's finished here, you can actually erase extra stuff, or you can restore some more. Like, let's say I wanted that bench to be restored. I could click there and then go through that process. But I'm just going to say apply. And then it should apply it to yours. I'm gonna go ahead and crop this down to just what I need of the image now that the background is actually gone. Perfect, so now I have a really nice picture of a piano. So maybe I'll make it much bigger and I can put it kind of in the background like this. Okay, awesome, I could even make it like even bigger than that. Like let's say I wanted to do like this in the background. Perfect. Okay, awesome. So I might do that a couple of times if I wanted to add a couple more instruments or sheet music or something in the background. But for now, I'm just going to stick with just the piano. The other thing that I highly recommend adding in is a picture of your face, a picture of you, right? We're trying to build the know, like, and trust factor with parents in order to encourage them to enroll and to enjoy, to join in for your class. So we can also do that by putting your face in the picture, right? Your class photo is one of the first things that they see as they're going through the Outschool platform. So what you can do is go to your uploads. And so you can upload an image of yourself into this platform. So let's say that I wanted that. So of course I would just drag and drop my photo into here, but I'm trying to find one that I already have of myself, for example. Let me scroll and find one. Okay, so for example, these ones here, I took these for YouTube for thumbnails. So they're kind of silly, but honestly, they're really perfect for something like this. So I could click on this and add in this photo of myself. And you see, of course, I'm smiling. I look very friendly. Yeah, easy to approach, all the things. So now, once again, we're going to go to edit image and then background remover again, and I'll let it process. All right, once it's finished processing, once again, the background will then be gone and I can erase or restore. And then I'm going to say apply. I'll crop it down a little bit. And then once again, I will make this larger. So the only thing that's a little bit risky about this one is the fact that it's so close over here to the side, because I will say that these Outschool course images, they'll be used for a variety of things. Sure, they'll be used for your class itself on the Outschool platform, but they also use them, for ads and advertisements like Facebook ads, Instagram ads, and sometimes that means that they crop off a bit of the sides. So usually I recommend that if you can move your face in a little bit, that you should. The only thing here is that my arm is cut off. So maybe for now I'll just leave it. And then once I upload it, maybe I'll see if it really cuts it off and I'll change it later if I want to. So here's me smiling, pointing like, woohoo, piano lessons. I could even go in edit image and I could adjust the brightness, the contrast, all of that stuff to make this photo look better if I wanted to as well. All right, and then I actually recommend personally putting text in your photo. I know that Outschool in the past has said if you have too much text, that they will limit how much they advertise your class with this course listing. But I have found that adding text is actually really, really beneficial because it makes it even clearer what the class is. It can be even more eye-catching. So I'm gonna go to text. And if you haven't already, I would take some time to, of course, create like some branding for yourself as a teacher and try to stick with the same colors, the same fonts and all that kind of stuff as you create all of your different course listings photos so that they look really similar. So the font that I usually use is this one. And so I'm gonna make it bigger. So of course this black, it's like really hard to see right here, right? And it's like covering up my face like that. So I might move it down. Maybe I'll make this piano a little higher up like that. Okay, so then let me move this up as well so that maybe I'll put it here at the bottom. Okay, so then of course you can change the color of your font right here. So maybe I'd change it to like a white so it's easier to see. I even sometimes will make some of these background photos a little bit transparent. So what you can do is click on the photo, go to this icon, and you can turn down the transparency so you don't have to see it entirely the full color or whatever. You can do it with your photo as well. But another thing that I also do is you can go to elements and you can actually add in like a little rectangle behind it or something like that to make it easier to read. So for example, something I've started doing recently is I'll add a rectangle like that. I'll make it the entire length of the image and then I will put it behind the photo like that. Okay, if you can't actually, if it's like in front of the photo like this, for example, then all you have to do is go to position and then say backward and then it'll be behind the photo. Or let's say like it's behind your body, then of course you can bring it to the front like that, okay? And put it right behind the text as well. So you can do it like that and you can say one-on-one piano. Okay, you don't wanna do too much text because once again, a lot of times these photos will get really small. So from far away, you still wanna be able to read it. So something big, bold, and easy to read and as few words as you can use as possible. I usually just do like 2 to 3 words in my photos personally. Another thing you can do with your text that can be great is if you go to effects, they even have some extra effects that you can do. So you can do like the background photo. So you can do that instead of this, for example. You could just put like a background color behind it. You could also change it to hollow if you wanted to feel like that. Although I think that's a little less bold. So usually I go with the splice instead and I just don't have it offset. And then I'll change the color of just the outside part like that. So you can change the color of the outside part. And then of course you can change the color of the text right here as well. So lots of options here. But the key thing of course is we want it to be colorful, eye-catching, polished, easy to understand what's going on. All right. And of course I could also actually make this transparent so that it's easy to see what's behind it still, but it's still easier to see the text. Maybe I'll even make the letters a little bit spacier so it's easy to read like that. Okay, so this is a great start. Maybe I, of course, would add a few more things, like maybe some music notes or something like that. But for now, I'll just go with this. So the next stage is you go to share, you say download, and make sure that you do it as PNG or JPEG. I would probably do PNG because it tends to be the nicer of the two. You say download. And then once this is downloaded, it'll save it to your computer and then you can upload it to the Outschool platform and use it as your course image. Improving your course listings is something that I talk about in depth with my clients in my program, the Online Teacher Accelerator, which is for teachers who want to build the foundations of their online teaching business and scale to full time. If that sounds like something you're interested in, then definitely check the links below to join the waitlist. All right, so hopefully this video was helpful for you to really up your game with your course listings photos. If this was helpful for you, please make sure to give it a thumbs up and hit the subscription button below. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.